come all ye faithful, joyful and triumphant. O come ye, O come ye to Bethlehem. Come and behold him, born the King of angels. O come, let us adore him.
Feliz Navidad, prospero año, feliz Navidad. Good morning, respected principal, sir, teachers, and all my dear friends. Now, I am going to start with the prayer. So, everyone, join your hands, close your eyes for the prayer. Our response, Lord, hear our prayer. We pray to the Almighty God during this Christmas season to bless our management, principal, teacher, that God may keep them protected during this COVID situation and provide them good health and mind to take good and prudent decision for the betterment of our school. Our response, God, hear our prayer. We pray for all our students that God may keep us too safe and protected from virus and help us to concentrate in our studies. Our response, Lord, hear our prayer. Let us pray for ourselves, for our brothers and sisters, parents and grandparents, all the members of our family, that God will take care of them and fulfill our hearts with Christ's gentleness, kindness, and mercy in this Advent season. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
Jingle bells, jingle bells. I love Christmas. And I love Santa.
Me too. But Tofu, do you know we call it Christmas because Jesus Christ was born that day?
Really?
No.
But now you tell me. Please tell me a Christmas story. Tell me Jesus Christ's birthday story.
Today, I'll tell you the most wonderful story of them all. The birth of Jesus Christ. The Christmas Story. About 2,000 years ago, in a small town called Nazareth, there was a little house where lived a young Jewish girl named Mary. She was not married, but she was going to be real soon, to a good man named Joseph. Well, one day, something amazing happened. An angel of the Lord, Gabriel, a very important angel, appeared to Mary. Who are you?
I am Gabriel. Don't be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. He loves you very much. God has sent me here to tell you that soon you'll have a son.
Huh? Me? A son?
Yes, a son. He will be called Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of God.
Mary was very obedient and she said,
I am the handmaid of the Lord. May God do with me as He wants to.
Mary wanted to do just as God told her to do. Just near the time Mary was about to have her baby, the Roman Emperor sent soldiers to announce a new law.
Okay, listen everyone. The Emperor Caesar Augustus says that all of you need to pay some taxes now and register for census.
So Mary and Joseph made their way to Bethlehem because that's where Joseph had to pay taxes. It was about 65 miles from Nazareth to Bethlehem. And the trip took many, many days. And when they reached Bethlehem, guess what happened? All the places were full. the inns were full.
Mary, you wait here. Make yourself comfortable. By then, I will try to find a suitable place for us to stay.
Joseph kept knocking and knocking again and again. He had been looking and looking for a place to stay. And Mary was about to have a baby.
Well, I have tried almost all the inns, and it looks like all of them are full. Dear Mary, how do you feel?
I am very tired, Joseph. But please don't worry. I am sure God will provide a place for us. Poor Joseph and Mary were so tired and didn't know what to do.
Oh God, tell me what to do. Help me. I have no idea, no clue.
It's sad that Mary and Joseph had no place to stay. No place to go.
A place no one would have expected the Son of God to be born in. It wasn't a palace, not some castle, not in a fancy building either. God's Son was born in a humble small stable.
I'll go and get some fresh hay where you can sleep comfortably tonight.
That night, Jesus was born. And oh, it was a wonderful night. Big star shining in the sky. There was no crib, so they laid baby Jesus in a manger. It was full of fresh hay and made it a little comfortable for the baby. Near Bethlehem, that night there were some shepherds keeping watch over their flocks of sheep. When suddenly, an angel appeared to them.
I have good news for you. There is a Savior who has been born.
What? Really? What Savior? Can we see him? Where is he?
The angel told them where to find him. The shepherds were so excited and happy. They ran to the stable. Jesus there, just as the angel had told them. After they had seen Jesus, they spread the news, and everyone who heard was in wonder. In wonder, just like you are. Doesn't it sound magical, Tofu?
So magical and fun, Tia. I am happy the angels took care of them all. Joseph, Mary, and baby Jesus. Thank you for telling me the Christmas story. I'll tell it to everyone in my school tomorrow.
That'll be great, Tofu. I love telling you new stories. But be careful, and don't fall off that ladder.
Good morning, respected principal sir, teachers and all my dear friends. I, Purushottam Nair of Standard 10th B, would like to say few words on today's occasion, that is Christmas. Christmas, it is a Christian holiday, but people of all religions celebrate it with great joy and happiness. On Christmas Day, we honor the birth of Jesus Christ. In the Christian religion, people believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. On the eve of Christmas, a midnight mass is considered as the most essential service for Christians. During this, all family members go to the mass and enjoy a massive feast of different delicacies. Due to this COVID-19 pandemic, we aren't able to arrange these services. But due to this, we have realized that Christmas is not about the festivities, but it is about the spirit and good feelings. While celebrating Christmas this year, let's hope that the cure for this pandemic is effective. Wishing you and your family health, happiness, peace and prosperity this holiday season and the coming new year. Thank you.
Good morning, respected teachers, principal and my dear friends. Today I am going to speak a speech on Christmas. Christmas is the season of love, harmony and celebration. This is a particular time to celebrate Jesus Christ's birth. Being a festival for Christians, this festival is celebrated by everybody with great joy. People light their homes with candles, decorations and Christmas trees, which is the must for symbolizing Christ. Christmas carols are one of the best things, or that can be said as the best charm of this festival, which is sung in the churches to welcome the occasion festivities. It is essentially Christmas that reminds us that we should stick to the essential aspects of mankind. In other words, during the celebration, we will share offer the less fortunate, spend time with loved ones and have a good view of life. Thank you.
Good morning everyone. I, Aditya Prabhu, on this occasion of Christmas, would like to recite a poem that captures the essence and spirit of this amazing and jolly season. Everyone is jolly. Everyone is happy. We can call this Christmas and it's time to have fun. Don't be gloomy. Appreciate the beauty. Just look at the stars and wish what you want. No time to worry, no need to hurry. It's time to relax, be thankful and be glad. Never feel lonely, you have a family. I give you these wishes to say Merry Christmas.
Poem on Christmas spirit. The wind is blowing with the cold breeze air. The children are singing everywhere. The laughter and joy will now be shared. These are the signs that Christmas spirit is in the air. The love that we give will now be fed. The messages we convey will now be sent. The poor and needy will now be fed. These are the signs that Christmas spirit is not yet dead. The people everywhere are having fun. The fathers are bonding with their son. The quarrels and fight are already done. These are the signs that Christmas spirit is not yet gone. Thank you.
Hi, this is Sarthak Thuri from 8A, Dr.Antonio Silva Technical High School. On Christmas Eve, we sit in front of the fire and take turns reading stories. Put them in your Christmas wish list. I should like to be at home on this Christmas day. Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
And heaven and nature sing. Joy to the world. and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and heaven and nature sing. Joy to the world, joy to the world, joy to the world.
Thank you.